And yet another couple of features that I know I would have liked right from the beginning as far as captions are concerned, but better late than never, is the ability to import, edit, and create captions in the SRT format. So even though there were easy ways of creating SRT files from ITT or CA6OA captions, it still was an additional, seemingly rather superfluous step one had to take. And with it, we of course get that little bit more compatible with sites such as YouTube and Facebook. But aside from that, you now also have the option to create open captions from 608 captions. Meaning if you've created closed captions in the 608 format, you can use these to automatically create burnt-in titles for your clip. Again, something that, until now, was only possible by jumping through various hoops and using third-party applications. But let's start at the top. I have a project here that already has German subtitles in the ITT format. I can now use these to either convert them into SRT formatted captions or use them to create SRT formatted captions in addition to the existing ones. To do that, I simply need to first create a new subtitle role. I can simply right-click one of the subtitles in my timeline and go to Assign Caption Roles, where I can already see that I only have ITT captions as an option. And here, just select Edit Roles, or if I don't have any captions at all yet, I can go into the Modify menu and select it here. Either way, the window for editing the library's roles opens. Here I just need to click the little plus button at the top right, labeled Caption Role, where I'm presented with the now three caption options that I can create. ITT and 608 at the top, now with the addition of SRT as my third. So selecting SRT adds a new SRT role with English as the default language. And as usual, I can, if I want to, use the small minus button in front of either to delete them. But since my subtitles are in German, I of course want to change them over, which I can do by clicking on the language button on the roles bar. And from the seemingly endless list of language options, I'll go to German and then Germany and select it. And since we'll need them in a minute, and I'm here anyway, I'll just create a 608 role as well and do the same. Now all I have to do is click Apply. Back in my timeline, if I didn't already have any captions, I could just hit Option C to create a new one. And in the pop-up at the top of the window that appears, I now see all three formats as an option. I'll just delete it again since I don't want any new captions, but would actually like to convert my existing captions so that I don't have to retype them all over again. Having selected one, all I have to do is hit Command A to select them all, right-click any one of them, and simply select Assign Caption Roles, and then whichever format I prefer. And since not every caption format supports the same text formatting and other things, something one should of course keep in mind when converting, I'm given a warning that the conversion could result in loss of text or formatting. I'll simply confirm by clicking Continue, and with that, I would now have the option to save my captions in the SRT format upon export. Alternatively, if I want to keep my ITT captions as well, I could also right-click and duplicate them into any random language first, and then simply assign the duplicates whichever other caption role, and with that caption format that I like. Now if I export my clip and look under the Roles tab, I can choose to output one or all caption files in their respective format as a sidecar file. These I can then simply upload alongside the clip itself to YouTube, Vimeo, Facebook, or whatever hosts I'm using that accepts either format. But there's actually one more thing that has been added that isn't quite as obvious. There's a new, rather inconspicuous button to the right of my video track labeled Captions. Clicking this actually gives me yet another window with two additional options. The first option giving me the possibility to embed my CEA608 captions directly into the movie file, assuming I even have any. Meaning I don't necessarily have to create a sidecar file for my 608 captions, but rather they can be extracted from within the clip itself. The second option probably being the one most people, again like myself, would have liked to have from the get-go. This option allows me to define which of the existing captions I can have used as open caption titles, meaning burnt-in subtitles that can't be deactivated. I'll just choose to embed my 608 titles, and then select my SRT captions to be burnt in. And export my clip so we can take a look at what that even means in practice. After exporting and opening the clip in the QuickTime player, you can see I now have an additional button in the navigation bar with the same icon we saw in Final Cut. Clicking this, of course, allows me to activate the now embedded captions. Scrolling through the clip, I can see that I also have the burnt-in titles, which clearly makes the embedded captions pretty pointless. But then there's even one more thing. If I re-import that same clip into Final Cut Pro, it gets a unique icon in the event with the little speech bubble on it, signaling me that it has embedded captions. But if that weren't enough, if I edit the clip back into my project, I can even right-click it, and I'm given the option to extract the captions at the bottom. Selecting this automatically generates caption files in my timeline, frame accurately, just as I set them up in the original clip. So that's pretty cool. By the way, should you choose to export a project using Final Cut Pro's YouTube API, for example, you'll even see the two options for including captions and burning in captions here at the bottom of the settings window as well. In which case, you obviously can skip having to upload a sidecar file in addition to the actual clip. So again, a very cool improvement for anyone working with subtitles of any kind.